When I was growing up, I was raised in a trailer park for most of the time. We didn't get an actual house until I was like in the 10th grade in high school. So in the trailer park, everybody used to, you know, go around and trade records, like 45s. And I don't know if this one came from back then, but they were like this, okay? And here we have Elvis with Tutti Frutti and blue suede shoes. So, I mean, come on. And it was so outrageous back in the day that Elvis was doing the hip bump that people were going nuts. But it was a thing that brought us all together in the trailer park. You know, the kids would all get together and trade records and put little initials on them so we know where they belonged and we could give them back. And I remember being on the front of a T-Bird and having like Frankie Valli or what. I mean, I'm old, okay? And I mean, I knew the lyrics to every single song on the radio, and I still do. You can't get them out of your head, you know? When I did Wayne's World, Mike Myers said he was gonna start a school where you could get lyrics out of your head, because sometimes they get stuck, you know? Later on in life, I started making movies, and I was hanging out with the people at Slash Records, and that's kind of right around the time I decided to do the Decline of Western Civilization movies. But X was the hottest band back then, and everybody would go to the X shows, and Xene was the most beautiful girl around, and John Doe was the most handsome guy around, and I always wanted him to be my boyfriend, but he always treated me like I was just a nobody. However, lately he tried to license some of the Decline, and I said no, so I got him back. Anyway, I have here a great song, White Girl, that Xene screams about being a white girl on. And we have copyright 1980 Slash Records. Yes, we were hanging out on the roof at on the top of Slash Records. And then after they did their original album for Slash Records, where I went out in the desert and we filmed it and put it in the Decline, where there's this burning X. And I kept having to like throw gasoline on the X so it would keep burning. And what happened was I went through the film and I picked a frame that looked like a guy, a man. It had a face on it and everything. The flames had a face on it. And that was the first X album cover. And then after that, they did the Wild Gift. I think this is a remake, you know, but these pictures really look like the guys and girl in the band in 1978, 70, you know, whenever we were shooting the Decline movies. And I don't know, they were all just so creative, and they all had, when they named this album, when I heard what the name of the album was gonna be, I'm like, what the hell does that mean? Wild Gift. And I realized that, you know, they're poets. X were and are poets. And they just like the way those two words sound together, I suppose. I don't know. I never understand the title of it. But they were always collecting little pieces of crap and putting them together. Look, there's John Doe with cards and little automobiles and all kinds of weird things. And actually, I don't have any tattoos except for the one right here that's four little dots. And when I was filming, I said to John, because he was giving Xene that Temptation, right here, Temptation tattoo that she has on her arm. And I said to John, does that hurt? And he went, bam, bam, bam. So I have four little marks right here that look like blackheads that I can't get off. But that's my only tattoo. So I do have my favorite band in the whole world. It's always hard to say who's your favorite band, you know, but I think if I had to, like, I'm on my deathbed and somebody goes, who was your favorite band in your whole life? I would go, Pink Floyd, and then die. Okay, because they're just like so many things, you know, they're so deep. And I tripped on acid at the Griffith Observatory and watched The Wall, you know. And it changed my life. And I got stopped by the cops on the way home, and I was still tripping, and I had to like walk the line really loaded. And I have very good balance, and so I did it, and it was okay. This is just a best of Floyd, you know, but here's the thing, it's got more of the wall, but then it's got my absolute favorite, Shine On, You Crazy Diamond, okay? And of course, Money. Why they would do a dance song album is silly, but I got all my real Floyd albums in my vault, and I didn't want to go down there and open it up. But that is my favorite band in the whole wide world. God bless Pink Floyd, and thank you for being ever around. If we're talking like late 60s, Penelope Spheeris entering film school at UCLA, totally into music, going to every concert I could possibly go to. When Black Sabbath came on the scene, it changed everything, okay? All of a sudden, the world of music was different. I mean, I always listened to the hard edge bands, you know, Cream and Blue Cheer and, I don't know, Zeppelin, I guess. I was never a big Zeppelin fan, honestly. I know that's crazy, but I wasn't. It was a little too melodic for me, you know, not angry enough. But then when we got Sabbath, my world changed. And, you know, this is something that is once in a lifetime for a band, honestly. I mean, even though they've been going forever and ever and ever, you know, this and Bloody Sabbath, for me are just... They were scary, and then they were also inspiring. That was the thing, is it was like a horror movie in an album, okay? But then you weren't scared anymore, and then you fell in love. And Ozzy's voice is still what it is. And then I couldn't believe, in 1999, I went out on tour with Ozzy and Sharon and shot the Ozfest movie. We sold ourselves for rock and roll. And they are still my friends today, and what a dream come true to fall in love in 1969 with Mr. Osborne, and then have him as a friend today. When I came up to UCLA from Orange County, which is where I lived when I was a teenager, then I started college, I heard there was a film school at UCLA. So I'm like, they have a school where they would teach you how to make film? Oh my God, I gotta go there. So I went to UCLA, and somebody told me about a concert that was gonna happen in the park at Griffith Park. And I went there all by myself, and I was wandering up the hills in Griffith Park, and I see this little stage. It must have been like 12 by 12, and it was a foot high. And there was a guy that was so beautiful singing on stage, and he had on a shirt with daisies all over it. It was Jim Morrison. And I and about 10 people stood there and watched the Doors perform. That was a wonderful, wonderful moment where I got to just stand there and look at this gorgeous man and this amazing music. And these are kind of crappy pictures, but and then later on, Manzarek was involved with the X people, you know, down at Slash. And then also I put Densmore in a film I did called Dudes in 1987. So I got a little connection there as well. Late 60s, mid to late 60s, Los Angeles, I moved up here, and I met a guy because I was working at IHOP, and I spilled blueberry syrup on him. And it was hippie days. He was wearing like a tablecloth, and he had hair all over the place. He was gorgeous. Anyways, he's the Bobby, the father of my daughter, Anna. And when I met him, he was so into music, and he actually really got me so into music. Every time a Beatle album would come out, me and Bobby, who were together for 7 years, had to be the first to be lined up at Tower to get the Beatle album, okay? I mean, when the White album came out, it was like, what the hell? And then it was like, wait a minute, Sgt. Pepper's, what the hell is this? You know what I mean? And we start looking at the picture and Sgt. Pepper's and trying to identify everybody and trying to understand what the words mean. And it's like, where did these guys come from? Where did the Beatles come from? That, were they just like aliens or something? How could they do this? So many songs, so beautiful, so many years. I mean, it shouldn't even happen in human existence. But the Beatles did it. Bobby died from heroin overdose, and every time I listen to the Beatles, I think of Bobby.